What's a green way to fertilize your lawn and garden and save money? Composting. My name is Sarah Taylor, Master Gardener and member of the Keep Port St. Lucie Beautiful Committee. Allow me to convince you to start composting. Because you already have all the components at home, you just need to put them together. What is compost? In a simple term, it's decayed organic material used as a plant fertilizer. Now, don't turn up your nose just yet. While composting may sound like a messy pile of garbage, in the gardening world, it is often referred to as black gold. That's because compost made from home typically has more nutrients than what can be bought at the store, and it's free. Instead of throwing your kitchen scraps and raked leaves from the yard into a trash can, throw them into a compost pile, and within a few weeks, you will have free fertilizer. I happen to be the laziest composter you will ever meet. I tend to throw it in the bin and forget about it. Sure, I am saving the landfill from kitchen scraps and yard waste, but when it comes time for me to actually want to use my compost, I have to do a bit more to prepare. So take a lesson from my mistakes and start your compost pile the right way. Two types of materials are needed for successful composting. Green materials, which are rich in nitrogen, and brown materials, which are rich in carbon. Brown materials include fallen leaves, shredded newspaper or cardboard, tea bags, and coffee grounds. Green material is just what it sounds like: kitchen scraps, eggshells, fruits, and grass clippings. Never include meat, bones, and foods with oils, dressings, or fats because they may attract animals or produce an objectionable odor. Also, the waste of your dogs and cats should not be used due to the possibility of diseases. Compost needs three things to be successful: food, water, and oxygen. But to hold all that together, you'll need to make a bin and find a location. First things first, make sure your bin is at least 3 foot by 3 foot by 3 foot. My makeshift bin is a trash can with holes drilled in it, and I find it incredibly hard to turn the pile because it's so narrow. So when you start your bin, be sure it's something you can maneuver around and within. I placed mine just outside the patio screen door, so it's a quick walk from the kitchen to the bin, but it's also hidden out of sight because, let's face it, it's not the most attractive looking feature of my garden. Once you've decided on a location and started contributing to your bin, you'll find that a new pile of green and brown materials will heat up rapidly. This is a reflection of the microbial activity. After 4 to 7 days, it will begin to cool and should be turned to mix the materials and allow the pile to heat again. See, that's my problem. I rarely turn my pile because it's cumbersome to maneuver in this can. Compost can be produced fairly rapidly in about 6 weeks if the pile is occasionally turned and watered if it's dry. Turning also shifts material from the outer, cooler part of the pile to the warmer center. My materials will still decompose at a much slower rate because they're rarely watered and turned. I just consider my black gold operation to be more of a long-term investment strategy and less of a get-rich-quick scheme. Or I'm just lazy. All joking aside, compost is an excellent soil amendment that improves the health and structure of both sandy and clay soils. It can be applied on top of soil as mulch, and when mixed with other components, it makes a good potting soil. It doesn't take much to start your own compost production. Consider building your own compost unit to help fertilize your yard, master your garden, and, of course, keep Port St. Lucie beautiful.